Hello, this is part one of my 11x11 ball construction videos. There are 5 videos in total and I will give the links to the others in the video and description when they are available. I hope to have all uploaded by March 2014. Although I've made puzzles this shape before, I've never done it on such a large scale. Right from the start, you can see how I'm struggling to hold the puzzle in order to work on it. You can't exactly put it in a vise, so I'm not sure the best way to do it. A lot of people have asked how it's possible to turn a cubic puzzle into a perfect ball. Actually, it's quite easy, though very time consuming. The logic is very simple. However much you scramble it, a ball doesn't have any parts that stick out. So to make a ball, you just cut off all the parts that do stick out. If it was a solid object, towards the end it would be very difficult to decide what bits are sticking out. On a puzzle, however, it's very clear just by moving it. This initial shaping involves sawing plus dremeling. There is no rule about when one should take over from the other, but I found the sawing quite awkward, so I was happy to change quite quickly. At every stage it's a good idea to check movement. This is my first attempt at such a project, and I have no idea if the puzzle will work or just fall apart at some stage. Some people have expressed concerns that a Dremel will cut your hand if it touches you. In reality, it's a bit like hot water. If you touch it by mistake and quickly move away, you won't get injured. The 11x11 cube I'm using here is an illegal knockoff, and I urge people not to buy them. I was sent this one for free. Companies often send me stuff in the hope that I will promote their product or company. If they are legit like Meffert's or Hong Kong Nail Store, I'm happy to help. When they are not, I refuse. Please remember that as well as violating copyright law, these puzzles are unlikely to have undergone the required safety checks in order for them to be sold in Europe and the USA. This initial shaping took just over 5 hours. The puzzle still feels fine at this stage, and I was gaining confidence that it might actually work. In part two, I will be taking the puzzle all apart and filling the holes. I will put a link in the description and at the end of the video when it is uploaded.